So let's talk a bit about Darshan. So Darshan is an I/O profiler. So the idea is that this tool will allow the application developer, or at least the application user, to know what is the cost of the I/O and where the time is spent in terms of I/O. So I'm not a Darshan developer, or I'm not linked to the Darshan team by any means. It's just that I've used this tool, and actually, I think it's a pretty cool tool. But there is other tools around in the community, but I found this one convenient, so I'm just going to talk about this one. So if we want to do I/O tracing on monitor the I/O, there is several places where we can position ourselves in order to observe this. So of course, there is the application. We can go also to the I/O library. We can go to the file system and ultimately to the storage device. Not all the layers have the same value. So typically, storage device is more interesting for the storage developer. So for people like us, the storage company, knowing what's going on at the storage device level is very interesting. Same thing for file system. As an end user, what is really important for you is not that much what's going on in a single drive. What you want to know is what is the cost of the I/O in your application. If there is no cost, then you don't care about, what's going on within the file system and the storage device. The I/O is not part of the to-do list to improve the application. You can focus on other things. So Darshan is a way to somehow to qu quantify the cost of I/O in the application. So I'm going to pass this one. So we can use F-Advice, but up to now, I've not met any developer using this. So the idea is that you can help the file system to cope with I/O by providing information. So Darshan, so this tool is pretty cool. This is not the single tool in the community, but the good thing is that there is the ability to observe the application without modifying the application itself, and even in most of the case, you don't need to recompile or anything. It can work out of the box. It has been deployed on several large HPC sites and used in production. So the idea is that people can use it, they run it within the job scheduler, and afterwards they can look at the performance report of the application for the I/O. It's coming from one of the national labs in the US, Argonne. So, since it's coming from a national lab, there is a strong focus on HPC, which is cool because we are HPC people. So, typically, there is a large part of the tool which is focused on MPI/IO. And you can also observe HDF5 and other, I will say, scientific specific I/O library. So it's not linked to any file system because the application itself is modified. So the idea is that basically there is symbol overloading during the linking time. So if the application is using a shared object, so a .so, the shared object symbol is going to be overloaded during the loading phase, the linking phase into the memory. And then the Darshan version of the I/O call will be triggered first, and Darshan will call afterward the original I/O function. So it's a convenient way to squeeze in somehow. If the binary is static, then there is no option for Darshan to overload the symbol during the linking phase because all the library are within the static binary. Then it means that we need to recompute, sorry for the typo, to recompile, sorry for the typo again. On recompiling a large scientific application, maybe not that cheap. So then some of the interest of the tool is decreasing a bit. So there is two key components in Darshan. The one which is going to collect the data, so the data acquisition part, so this is Darshan runtime. So this is really instrumentation of the application. So we patch the application in order to insert the Darshan probe, and we will collect the information during the execution of the app. And then there is a Darshan utils, which is the way to basically to pass and analyze the data which has been acquired during the execution. So it means that since the runtime is collecting data, of course, the I/O profile that you will get through the dashboard analysis will depend on the parameters that you have used for your application. So typically, do not expect to have the same I/O profile if you change the data set of your app. So if you use your app with a specific data set, things, for instance, to a matrix multiply, then you will have a very different profile that if you use the same application, but with a much, much, much larger matrix, for example, which will trigger out of core aspect and so on. So good things is that for the summer school, Darshan has been pre-installed in the virtual machine. So you don't need to worry about how to install Darshan. It's pretty easy to install. There is a, actually, I think they have moved on GitHub. So even this slide is slightly outdated. You download and there is a bunch of compilation and that's it. But everything is pre-installed. So you will be able to do the hands-on exercise today without taking care of this installation. So to use it, it's pretty simple. We have to specify where the log file, where the data collected during the execution are going to be stored. And that's kind of it. There is a bit of documentation if you're interested, but I hope that we will answer most of the questions during the live session today. And once the file has been collected, I mean the log file, so the data has been collected, there are several ways to analyze them. So we can look about the individual I/O, or we can generate pretty cool summary. So we will look at some of them now. So this is a typical job summary. So Darshan has generated a lot of data during the instrumentation of the application. But then when you call the job summary.pl, it generates a PDF and you can look at the PDF. And what is interesting is that this is a kind of hierarchical reading. The first information is what is the cost of I/O. Here on this example, you can see that basically the cost of I/O is at best, I mean, at worst 5% of the application time. So pink is really dominant and pink is compute. So we can say that this application is not, the I/O override is limited. Of course, it's always good to improve to get 5% speed up, but you will only get 5% speed up if you work only on I/O on this app. And then, so this is, let's say that this first thing is, do I need to read the following part of the summary report? Here we could say like basically no, it's an I/O bound application. But nevertheless, then we have more detailed information. So is it POSIX? Is it STDIO? What is the access size of my application? So here we see that basically everything is both for read and write is around 100K to 1 megabyte. So we all the I/O are in this bucket, which is okay. So 100K, 1 megabyte, I would consider this as large I/O. So it's good for the storage device. It's not fragmented I/O. Then you can have more information. What is the file? What is the file system? What is the amount of bytes? So this is a very good, for instance, because most of the time, the cost of I/O is not evenly distributed into the application. There is a couple of files which are somehow the hotspot. So even it's quite often a single file. Let's say that when you have a reduce, all the processes are writing to the same file. This is where the cost is high currently for most of the file system. So you can see Darshan parser, we pass the name of the log file, and then the parser is going to provide us a lot of information. So here this is detailed, so if you want to dig in, further, after reading the summary, say, oh, this is interesting, there is an I/O issue, then you can use this to go into more detail. And the more detailed mode is actually named the extended tracing. So extended tracing, it's not only about more detailed analysis, this is also a more detailed acquisition. So Darshan is making normally statistics about the IO. You saw during the summary this bucket of 1 megabyte POSIX. So the information are collected in memory and written down into the log file. But if you enable DXT, then every individual IO operation is going to be written down into the log file. So it means that somehow it's more intrusive. So the overhead of monitoring your application is higher, but you get a much more detailed view of what's going on because you get a per IO operation information on the cost. And then you have a DXT parser, which allow you to look into every single IO onto, so you can script and do your own analysis. So yeah, I've put an example. So I set this export DXT enable. So I switch on the detail tracing. I specify the log path where the log is going to be run. I launch my application using LG preload. So we ask the linker to first load Darshan.so before loading the application. The application is IOR. It's a well-known IO benchmark. We run the application, and then the result, the log file has been produced. So this is 2021 A23 Ubuntu blah blah. And I run Darshan DXT parser to have information. What do I have within this file? Of course, the file is in binary format in order to be more compact on the file system. And with the DXT parser, I can have the information of every IO. So for instance, this is reproduced in the last screenshot on this slide. You see that I can have for each individual write, which offset, what is the length, what is the start time and end time. And so we can compute, we can do our own analysis, check for outlier and things like that. So this is a very detailed analysis, not free to connect, but then if you want to address a performance bug, it can be convenient. So there is other tools. So, you know, in for every tool, there is kind of an ecosystem. So there is the Darshan Diff, which allow to compare different log files, which can be quite convenient. For example, if we just change one parameter in the application and we observe that the IO cost is not the same, with Darshan Diff, it could be easy to observe. We can backport old log file to the new version in the virtual machine of the summer school. We have installed the latest version of Darshan, which I think is 3.3.1. And we have this DXT analyzer, which allow to analyze the DXT file, so the detailed file. And now for the hands-on, normally we are supposed to do this after the coffee break, so we can maybe check back on site.